Gemara tells us that included in the pasuk Zochas Yom Shabbos Lakatsha in Aseres Hadibros is the mitzvah of reciting Kiddush. The Tanoim understand that the word Zochor, the verb Lizkor, means to remember, and Lahazikir means to mention. So the Tanoim understand, the Chachamim understand, Zochas Yom Shabbos Lakatsha means to speak about Shabbos, to mention the Kedushas Hayom of Shabbos, and recite Kiddush. So Leitchik used to say that when the bare minimum is you have to recite Kiddush, and if a person sings as Miris, Baruch HaBesimcha Oel HaYehudim, Yom Zeh Mechubin Mikol HaYomim, and you sing Miris and speak about the uniqueness of Shabbos and the specialty and the Kedushas HaYoyim, the Shevach HaYoyim, this is a Hemshech of the mitzvah of Kiddush. Because in Kiddush, the Rambam says it's not sufficient just to say, today is Shabbos, to say, you come and you greet someone, good Shabbos. So Rabbi Kalegi writes that the Yotze, the mitzvah of Kiddush, by reciting, just giving a blessing, good Shabbos, just to say today is Shabbos. And the Mishnah Berurah Tainus, how can it be so? The Rambam says, well, in the Sefer Mitzvahs and the Mishnah Berurah, you want the Yotze Kiddush, if you mention Shevach HaYom, you have to say that Shabbos is a special, unique day, special property. So that's not what Leitchik said. I think some Rishonim say that. I got it from the Rishonim, that reciting some of this Miris, that speak about the uniqueness in the Sheva Hayyim is a hemshech of the mitzvah. You're enhancing the mitzvah of Kiddush. So the Gemara has a discussion. This understanding, this translation of the word Zachar means lahazikir, to mention, we find it in other places also. In the Megillah, we read about the mitzvahs that we observe on Purim. We don't say, what about Mikra Megillah? Where does it say that you have to read the Megillah? So the Gemara says in the first half, so the word Nizkarim doesn't mean that the days are remembered, it means the days are spoken of. The days on Nizkarim are spoken of, means Mikra Megillah. The word Nizkarim is a reference to the Mikra Megillah. That's the whole source of Kriyas HaMegillah. And the Megillah says that is Ayam Vayla and Nizkarim. The same thing, Zacharias Shos Halacha Molech. So the Gemara says, Yachub Aleiv. Fulfill the mitzvah by thinking about it, remembering in your mind. It says at the end of the parsha, you shouldn't forget. Zachor is b'peh. So there also, the Tanaim on the Sud Zohar means lahaskir. You should mention, you should be the parsha of Amalek to fulfill the mitzvah of Zachirus Amalek. So the Gemara has a discussion regarding reciting of Kiddush. The Gemara says the reciting of Kiddush is the real din d'oraisa. Gemara's lashon is, Gemara says that Kiddush should really be a mitzvah sasei shazman rama, and as such, women should really be exempt from the mitzvah. Gemara says this is one of the exceptions to the rule, just like a matzah is an exception to the rule, just like hakel is a mitzvah sasei shazman rama, it's an exception to the rule. A lot of exceptions to the rule. There could be that there are more exceptions to the rule than there are mitzvahs that fall under the rule of mitzvah sasei shazman rama that women are put from. So Gemara says Kiddush is one of the exceptions to the rule. Gemara's lashon is Nashim Chayev is Bekiddush Hayom Dvar Torah. How do you translate the word Dvar Torah? If you would have asked me, the Rambam didn't ask me. If you would have asked me, I would have said Deraisa. It's not a din the Rambam. Women are Chayim Kiddush Deraisa. The Rambam says the word Dvar Torah has an added meaning. He says that it's Pshuto Shal Mikra. That Kiddush is Pshuto Shal Mikra. You shouldn't think that it's a drasha of the Torah Shabbat. But the Rambam wrote a Sefer Mitzvahs where he lists off which are the 613 mitzvahs. So the question, what do you mean 613? There are millions of mitzvahs. Every second there's another mitzvah to do. What do you mean only 613? So the Rambam, the first half of the Sefer Mitzvahs, the Rambam lists off 14 guiding principles, 14 klolim, 14 shaloshim, that determine whether any given mitzvah belongs in the listing or not. So the first klol the Rambam writes is you only count mitzvahs deraisa, you don't include mitzvahs derabanan. Because the Gemara's lashon is Taryak Mitzvah is Namal Ol Moshe Misinai. Moshe Rabbeinu wasn't given the Din of the Rabban. The next Klal the Rambam writes, you only include mitzvahs that are the Fipshuto Shal Mikra. There's a drasha of the Torah Shabbal Peh that can't be included in the Minyan of Mitzvahs. Because the Rambam Shita is that in every generation, the Chachmei HaTorah have the right to darshan. The way they see fit, they can add on another mitzvah. Every generation, they're going to add on another mitzvah, so you are going to have 614 mitzvahs, so you have to throw out an earlier mitzvah. Whenever you add on in every generation, the Chacham add on another mitzvah, so you have to throw out an earlier mitzvah. It can't be. Can't be. The Rambam has this disagreement with the Goyim. The Goyim say that every single din was a tradition from Moshe Rabbeinu and Har Sinai. The Chachamim and the later generations never invented any new drushes on the Torah Shabbat. And all the drushes of the Torah Shabbat is only a sort of a mnemonic device for the Zikaron to remember correctly what the Halacha Moshe Messina was. They're going to take it literally. Every single Sikkot in the Mishnah Berurah was told to Moshe Rabbeinu. So the Rambam says that's ridiculous. In every generation, the Chachamim used the Yud Gimel Midas, the Darshan new dinim that we never heard of before. How can it be that they had everything from us? It's just not true. The Gemara says in the Baisheni, they did Nisach Hayayim differently from the way they did in Baisrishan. Baisrishan, they Darshan the Pasuk one way. And after 70 years of Kollel's bubble, they built the second base of English, hung up a shingle on the new management, and we're going to do the Nisach HaYayin differently. They went against the whole, for the 410 years, they did Nisach HaYayin one way, because the Chachmei Shlaim HaMelech and the Chachmei HaTorah, during the Baisrishan period, felt that the way you read the Pasuk is one way. By Sheni, they darshan the Pasuk differently. So not that they had, everything was a tradition of Moshe Messina, the Chachamim in every generation, darshan the Pesukim, they're entitled to an opinion, if they're right to an opinion, they're dashing the psukim the way they see fit. And that's what the Rambam says in Shoresh Beis in the Sefer Mitzvahs. You can't include mitzvahs that are only known through a drasha of the Torah Shabbat. You've got to have more than 613. In every generation, they're mechadish new din, based on the new insights into the Chumash. So the Rambam says, what about Kiddush? He does include Kiddush as one of the 613 mitzvahs. So he says, no Kiddush, that's pshut shal mikra. Aryeh, Gemara says, Nashim Chayav is Bikirish Hayom Dvar Torah. The Rambam says, the word Dvar Torah doesn't only mean Deraisa. He says, I don't know how he knows it. He says, the phrase Dvar Torah means that it's Pshuto Shal Mikra. That's Pshuto Shal Mikra, so it belongs in the Minyan Mitzvahs. So the Gemara says that this is an exception to the rule. Reciting of Kiddush on Shabbos is an exception to the rule, the Hainu. The rule is that usually women are exempt from Mitzvah says the Shazbam. And Kiddush is one of the many exceptions. Women are Chayav. How do you know? Because there's a concept of a hekesh. What's a hekesh? Hekesh means that you have two dinim written in the same pasuk. So we assume there must be some connection, one with the other. Why did the Chumash write the two dinim in the same pasuk? So that's if you have two dinim in the same pasuk. What if you have something better than that? What if HaKadosh Baruch Hu said both statements bevasachas? Not one is the first half of the pasuk, one is the second half of the pasuk. HaKadosh Baruch Hu did a stunt. And he said two things simultaneously. The Gemara has a lashon mashein hapei yichol ledaber, aloha ozen yichol leshmoy. The human being can't say two things at the same time. There are people who talk out of both sides of the mouth at the same time. That's a different thing. But he can't say two sentences at the same time. So the Rebbeinu Shlom did it. He did a stunt, but he proclaimed the Aseres Hadibros at Maimon HaSinai. So the Gemara says there are two versions. One version in this week's Sedra in Yisrael. One version in Bais Chana. The Gemara says there's a contradiction between the two versions. Did the Rebbeinu Shlom say, what did he say? Did he say Zachar Siyam Shlomis Lekatsha? Did he say Shomer Siyam Shlomis Lekatsha? So the Gemara says he said both simultaneously. The contradiction, the apparent contradiction between the two versions. What was written on Sefer Sedra? The Gemara says they're both said simultaneously. So the Gemara understands that Shomer Siyam Shlomis Lekatsha is a loisese. Zachar is a mitzvah sase. Shomer is a mitzvah loisese. Says, who gets Malkus? The Pasuk says in Chumash, if the Bezdin ascertains that somebody is a Rasha, so you give him Malkus. Yeshiva is a Rasha, Vahayon Binako is a Rasha. The Bezdin establishes that Ploinik, somebody is a Rasha, and we give him Malkus. Who's a Rasha? So the Mizrahi holds that the Turekarta is a Rasha, and Turko holds that Mizrahi is a Rasha, everybody holds that everybody else is a Rasha. So who gets Malkus? Gemara says, Nechumish Dvarim, Yudarshan Smuchim. The Hekish means that you have two dinim written in the same pasuk. Smuchim means you have two dinim, one pasuk next to the other. And the Gemara says that the generally accepted opinion is you only darshan smuchim, two pasukim, one next to the other. In Mishnah Torah, only Chumish Dvar. That's the Gemara in the beginning of Yevamos. In the rest of the Chumash, you don't darshan smuchim. There are many, 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 many very famous dinim that are based on smuchim and Chumish Dvar. So one of the many famous halachas is who gets Malkus a Rasha? Which Rasha? How do you establish which Rasha? The Gemara says the very next parasha talks about losachsam shor b'dishay. Not allowed to muzzle an animal when it's threshing and doing work with food. You have to let the animal eat, nibble on the food. So the Gemara says, whoever violates a lav, which is dumi the lav da chasima, similar to the lav of lasach mishavidisha, gets malchus. Whoever violates a lav that's not dumi the lav da chasima doesn't get malchus. So the Gemara has a whole discussion in the third perek in Makkos, elein alaykin, what's considered, all the tanoim subscribe, that's the cloud. You only get malchus if you violate an avera that's dumi the lav da chasima. The tanoim discuss, what are the properties? What do you have to do that it should be similar to Osachsim Shabbatishim? So what are the Kollel is? It has to be written in Chumash. If you only know a prohibition from Torah Shabbat Peh, it's not even written in Chumash at all. It's not doing the Lav Nechassim. The Rambam writes so much that if a person eats Orlo B'chutzlots, he planted a tree, so you're not allowed to eat the fruits that grow the first 3 years. Sometimes no fruits can grow the first 3 years. They broke the hook. But if fruits do grow the first 3 years, then it's Orlot, Sosab Achil, Osab Ano. So the Rambam quotes the Gemara, in Chumash, the Parshas Kedoshim, the mitzvah of Orlot only says in Eretz Yisroel. It's an agricultural mitzvah. The mitzvah of Sakhlis Bor is only applied in Atara in Eretz Yisroel. So the Pasuk in Chumash Vayikra, Parshas Kedoshim, says, Kisabayal ha'aretz, when the Titan colleagues Nachal, Baraltam Arlos, and you come into Eretz Yisrael, you plant a fruit-bearing tree, you're not allowed to eat the pears that grow. The pears grow, you're not allowed to eat the pears that grow the first 3 years. So the Gemara has a tradition that there's a machlekes, the Rambam paskens that Orlo b'chutz lortz, halochal mosh nesim. If somebody plants a tree in America, so the fruits grow the first 3 years, they're not allowed to eat it. But the Rambam says there can't be any malchus, because it's not doing the law of the chasima. It's not written in Chumash at all. Chumash only says Kisavayah Haaretz. So Orlo B'chutz Lortz is purely halacha Moshe Nisina. So the Rambam says there can't be any monk. Such a Rashi. So and also says the same thing. We have a lav that's only known through halacha Moshe Nisina. So you can't get malchus because it's not doing in the lav that hasim. So the Gemara says, in order to get malchus, it has to be a lav that's written in Chumash. It's only known through halacha Moshe Nisina. It's not doing in the lav that hasim. And it has to be written B'loshen Lo, like Lo sachsam shabbatisha, or Yisham echen bi'al is also equivalent to lo. So Gemara says Yisham ucha benegat zaras. Gemara says that's a loy says, because the word Yisham there has a connotation of a lav. So here, the two members, the two sukim that HaKadosh Baruch Hu said b'vasacha simultaneously, zocher sam shabbos lekatcha is a mitzvah sese to recite kiddush. Shomer is Hamasham is Lakatra. Shomer is a loisese, because it's like Hisham and Penleal, and that's a loisese and not the Dumalach of the Shabbos. So the Gemara explains that Noshim are exempt only from mitzvah sase shazman grama. If you have a mitzvah loisese shazman grama, not the Dumalach of the Shabbos, not the Dumalach of the Yantiv, that's a mitzvah shazman grama, but it's a mitzvah loisese. So loisese shazman grama, women are mechudim, only mitzvah sase shazman grama. Women are put. So the Gemara says, since Zachar v'Shama were both Nemru v'Dibra Echad, they're both proclaimed simultaneously, the Gemara says that it's better than a Hekesh. A Hekesh means V'Akadosh Baruch Hu told Moshe Rabbeinu a Pasuk. So there's a first half of the Pasuk and the second half of the Pasuk. So since the both Dinim are written, were proclaimed together in one Pasuk, one half after the other half, so that constitutes a Hekesh. But if you have two Dinim that were proclaimed Mamish simultaneously, the Dibur Echad Namru. Mashena Peyachal the Dabba Belahos in the Cholishma. So that's better than a Hekesh. So that's what the Gemara explains. Since the women are Musar, not to violate Shomar, not to do Moloch of the Shabbos, because that's a Loises and Shazman Groma. So therefore, women are Muchim in Kiddush, despite the fact that Kiddush should have been a mitzvah, Sase Shazman Groma. The women should have been exempt, like Tzitzis and Tvilim. So it's an exception to the rule. The Ramban, Parshas Yisroel has a very long essay on the Pasuk Zocher Shabbos Kachi. Has a lot to say. I'd just like to mention a little bit. Every line in the Ramban there is very fascinating. A lot of famous Ramban HaChumash. This is one of the more famous Rambans. Ramban raises an issue that he got from the Ibn Ezra. Why is the Gemara only concerned about Zocher Shomer? There are other apparent contradictions. The two versions of that, Seres HaDibros, between Parshas Yisro and Parshas Paschana, there are other discrepancies. How come they're only concerned about Zocher v'Shomer? He has a very fascinating comment. He says, when the Chumash quotes what somebody said, when the Chumash quotes what it said in the Aseret Hadibros, it's what the Rebbe Shlom said, proclaimed in the Aseret Hadibros, it's not necessarily a verbatim quotation. You're going to tell me that when it quotes Paro, when it quotes Lavan, when it quotes Yaakov Avinu, it's a verbatim quotation? He says, not necessarily. The Chumash gives you the gist of what the people said. So that all the other discrepancies between the text of the Aseret Hadibros as it appears in Yisra appears for Aschana, it could be that the Aseret Hadibros didn't say either version. It could be it said a third version. The Chumash doesn't give you, Chumash Namuchiv to give you a direct quotation verbatim, gives you the gist of what it said. Could be that it didn't have either version. But Zach v'Shamar, what is the gist of the mitzvah? Is it a mitzvah saseh, or is it a mitzvah slice saseh? The world's apart, the Ramban says. Zohar is a mitzvah saseh. Yishomer is a shamah pen bial is a mitzvah slice saseh. So what is the gist of the mitzvah? Then the Ramban adds on more. A mitzvah saseh and a mitzvah slice saseh are two worlds apart from each other, different. He says, mitzvah saseh, we have a mitzvah to this, to demonstrate a love for HaKadosh Baruch Hu, we have to Hashem Elokecha. We have a mitzvah sesei to fear HaKadosh Baruch Hu, es Hashem Elokecha tira. So the Rabban writes that all of the mitzvah sesei flow from the mitzvah of Avas Hashem. To demonstrate that we love HaKadosh Baruch Hu, we go out of our way to fulfill all the mitzvahs that we know will make him happy. He wants us to observe these mitzvahs, so we do the mitzvah sesei. That demonstrates Avas Hashem. All of the mitzvahs loises and all the averus, all the lavin flow from the mitzvah of Yiras Hashem. We have to demonstrate fear of Hashem. So if Hashem doesn't want us to do something, we don't do it because we have to demonstrate we're afraid he's going to punish us if he's going to violate it. So the Ramban says there are two different types of a mitzvah. One stems from its successive flow from Avas Hashem, and the lavin flow from Yiras Hashem. So there are two different types of mitzvahs. So that was the Gemara. The Gemara was only worried about this discrepancy. What did it say in Aseret Hadibros? It could be that everything that's quoted in the Chumash is only the gist of what it said. It could be that neither version was there. But the question was, the version that was there in Aseret Hadibros wasn't a mitzvah sesei, it wasn't a loy sesei. And that's when the Gemara has to come up with this chiddush, that it was b'dibur echadem. Then the Ramban adds on another fascinating line. Which is on a higher madrega, Avas Hashem or Yiras Hashem? An interesting philosophical chakir. So he claims that Avas Hashem is the greater of the two. You should love HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And for Aryeh, the proof is, this is the Ramban's proof, very, you learn Gemara, it's not so clear that it says that the Gemara corresponds to what the Ramban says. Ramban says, the fact that we have a principle that mitzvah says, Dach and mitzvah slay says, sometimes when there's a conflict between the mitzvah says and mitzvah slay says, so under certain condition we say, Esedach alay says. Rabban says that's an indication that mitzvah seseh that stems from Avas Hashem is on a higher level than Yiras Hashem. That's why Esed Dechalei seseh. Very interesting comment. Rabbi Yosef Engel, in one of his essays, picks up upon this theme of the Ramban, and he says we have an interesting Gemara in Zvachim, towards the end of Zvachim. The Gemara says Esed Dechalei seseh doesn't apply in the Beis Hamikdash. Ein Esed Dechalei seseh sheba Hamikdash. The Gemara says we have a din. Let's say you have a group of 15 people are shutfim in the Korban Pesach, and they're all saying the Haggadah, and one guy takes him longer till he says the Haggadah. So by the time he gets to eating the Korban Pesach, they already ate everything up. They didn't leave any flesh for him. So what's he going to do? He has to eat a kazayis of flesh. So the Gemara says if you eat the marrow inside the bone, the marach inside the bone, it's roi l'achila. So you can be yotze the mitzvah b'achilas Korban Pesach, but you're not allowed to chew the bone. Not allowed to break the bone, not allowed to cut the bone open in order to get the marach inside. And even if the bone is so soft that you can eat the whole bone, the Rambam says he's still not allowed to, because that's a violation. That's the Masij Burubo. So the Gemara says the guy's stuck. If the other 14 shutim in the Korban Pesach ate up all the meat and there's nothing left for him, can only chew the bone and eat the marrow, he's not allowed to do that. Why don't you say, Esed Dechalei Seseh? He has a mitzvah seseh to eat the Korban Pesach and he can only fulfill the mitzvah by violating the law of Shemira Setzen. Gemara says, Ein Esed Dechalei Seseh Sheba Migdash. Why should that be so? How come it based on Migdash is different? So Yosef Engel has an interesting idea. He says, we have a pasuk, Umigdashi Ti Ra'u. We should fear Beis HaMikdash. So the Gemara says in Yevamos, what do you mean? You walk in Beis HaMikdash, you have to be afraid the walls are going to collapse on you. The sturdy walls, they built it very well. Mikdash Yitiro means, Lom in HaMikdash HaTam Yisirei. You don't have to fear the Beis HaMikdash. You have to fear HaKadosh Baruch Hu, who told you to make a Beis HaMikdash. What do you mean fear HaKadosh Baruch Hu? All over the world there's a din. It's Hashem Melkecha Tiro. So apparently, Rabbi Yosef Emel says, the pasuk tells me Mikdash Yitiro, in Beis HaMikdash you have to emphasize Yiras Hashem over Avos Hashem. Outside of the Beis HaMikdash we emphasize Avos Hashem. When you're in the Beis HaMikdash, in the Palton Shel Melech, then you have to emphasize Yiras Hashem. Because in Beis HaMikdash you have to emphasize Yiras Hashem over Avos Hashem, and that's why Ein Eset Dechol Eses Yishev HaMikdash. An interesting comment. Gemara in Brachas Daf Chav. Gemara says, despite the fact that Kiddush should have been considered a mitzvah saseh shazman grama, women should be exempt, it's an exception to the rule that women are high because hafen high be'os on this. What about other mitzvahs on Shabbos that is man grama? What about Shabbos Shudas? What about Lecha Mishneh? We usually assume, most Rishonim assume, that the whole mitzvah of Shabbos Shudas is only been Rabbanan. For us, some Rishonim would think that is their eyes, but that's not the generally accepted opinion. Lecha Mishneh, we assume, is also in the Rabbanan. Everything is Zeichel Amon. Lecha Mishneh is Zeichel Amon. We should remember the Ness. That an Erev Shabbos, a double portion of Mon came down. Every day Mon came down, except for Shabbos. And Yom Tov said, Erev Shabbos, Erev Yom Tov, double portion came down. We should eat Lecha Mishneh on Shabbos, Zeichel Amon. And we should have three Sudas on Shabbos, because also the Psukim seem to imply that the Mon was divided into three. The Mon that they ate on Shabbos, they had three meals. They had one meal Friday night, Shabbos morning, and Shabbos afternoon. They had the third Suda, three Sudas. It says the word Hayom. Hayom Lam Tzim Tzim Basada. Chlu Hayom, Kishabbos Hayom Lashem, Hayom Lam Tzim 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 Basada. So the three times the word Hayom has the connotation, implies that they ate three Sudas of the Mon. The original ox gold mirrors that they put out is a numerous mistake. They were in a rush to put out their English edition of the Zmiris. So somebody looked in the Aruch HaShulchan. The Aruch HaShulchan wrote that you have three Sudas on Shabbos, Zechel Le'Hamon. So the fellow translated it that Haman attended three meals in the Book of Esther. And we want to remember, we want to reminisce about Haman. It has to do with the Mon, not Haman. It's not Haman, it's Hamon, Zechel Le'Hamon, not Zechel Le'Hamon. The next edition, they corrected it. Okay. Even art school can make a mistake. Look at that. So the Pashta says that the Shalashudas and the Lecha Mishneh is a takonim, the Rabbanu Zecha Lamon, we should remember the miracle. So the Shailas is a mitzvah, the Shazman Groma. And Tosis writes, Tosis disagrees with Rashi. Tosis' opinion is that women are exempt from mitzvah, the Shazman Groma is not restricted only to mitzvahs derais, even applies to mitzvahs derabanan. Even a mitzvah derabanan, called the tikkun rabbanan came derais. A tikkun, if the chachamim introduce a mitzvah derabanan, which is man groma, the women will be potter as well. So the shailas are women mechuyev to have shalashudas and lecha mishneh. So the Rabbi Natam and the Ran both say the same thing, that women are mechuyev in both lecha mishneh and shalashudas, but they write different reasons why. So Rabbi Natam is quoted by the Ran. Rabbi Natam says that women are chayiv in shalashudas and lecha mishneh because since it's zechel anes, zechel aman, so we should apply the rule of afin hai biosanes. The Gemara says that women are obligated to be madlak ner chanukah despite the fact that it's zman grama. Women are obligated to have arbekaisis. Women are obligated to eat the haseda on Pesach night. All dinim derabbanan. Women are obligated to hear the Megillah. All four arbekaisis and haseda, Megillah, and hablokas ner es chanukah. They're all zechel anes. So since the women were also involved, afin hai biosanes, so we say that women should be mechuyev in these mitzvahs derabbanan. That's what the Rabbi Natan says over here also, that Shalashudas and Lecha Mishneh, Zechel Aman, the Nisim involved with the Man. So women are Mukhiv the same as the men because Afin Hai Biyosanes. The Ran agrees with the Rabbi Natan, Aloch HaLamayisim, that women should be Mukhiv in Shalashudas and Lecha Mishneh, but he gives a different reason. He says the Rabbi Natan should have said a better reason. We say Zoch HaVishamar. It's one Kedusha Sayyim, that's Mechayim and Zohar, Mechayim and Shomer. So since the kedushas hayayim of Shabbos is relevant for the women vis-a-vis the shamar, because that's a loisa, so even though it's a zman grama, so the kedushas hayayim is one kedushas hayayim, so the same kedushas hayayim is machayv the women in the mitzvah sesei. That's what it means. B'di berecha demu. It says one kedushas hayayim, that's machayv bo. So with the rabbanan, it's the same kedushas hayayim, that's machayv mishal shudis and vacha mishnah. So that should be kol sheyeshna bezeh, yeshna bezeh. It's one package deal. Either the kedusha sayam is relevant for the women or it's not. So the Gemara says that it is relevant. The mechuyif to observe shomer because it's a lo seser shazman ram. So therefore, the mechuyif to say kiddush min haTorah because the kedusha sayam is relevant. So who at the nami shalashud is nalecha mishna. It's all one kedusha sayam. So you have to understand the Ron thinks the Rabbeinu Tam didn't have to write what he said. Why didn't the Rabbeinu Tam realize that also? Why don't you just say it's one Kedusha Sayyam? So apparently Rabbeinu Tam, perhaps, I can't say apparently, that's apparent. Perhaps the pshat is that the Rabbeinu Tam thinks that that's not what it means. Zachar v'shamar, kol sheyeshnem v'shamar, yeshnem v'zachar. Doesn't mean that it's one Kedusha, it's a Tosis Yishanim, the beginning of Yevam, it writes like that. That kol sheyeshnem v'shamar, yeshnem v'zachar, because it's one Kedusha Sayyam. And either the Kedusha Sayyam is relevant for you or it's not. And since it's relevant for the women, this is the lav of Shamar, so it's relevant to the Kedusha Sayyam is Machayv and the Yaseh as well. So it could be the Rabbeinu Tam didn't understand it like that. Could be the Rabbeinu Tam understood differently. That Noshe Machayv and Kiddush, because Kiddush is connected with the Yisra Malacha. The Rambam writes an interesting Loshen towards the end of Hilchot Shabbos. The Rambam writes that one observed, there are some people who are retired, they live in an old age home, and they don't lift a finger. They don't wash their clothing, it's taken care of. They don't cook their meals, they don't turn on the lights, they don't turn off the lights, everything is taken care of. They don't lift a finger on Shabbos. They don't do any malacha, not on Shabbos, not all week long. So the Rambam says, in order to observe Shvisa Shabbos, you need a Shvisa Hanikaris. It has to be noticeable that all week long you do a malacha, and Shabbos you don't do malacha. If they're retired, and they're not old, they're not so healthy, and everything is taken care of. So how do you have a shvisa on your keres? So the Rambam thinks that's perhaps why they instituted din midrabbanan of muktzah, that it should be a shvisa on your keres, that the shvisa mamlacha should be more noticeable. So it could well be that the Rabbeinu Tam thinks that that's the pshat kol sheyeshna mishomer, yeshna mizochar. The women have to observe shmira Shabbos, but you want that it should be a shvisa on your keres. It should be noticeable that you're abstaining from malacha, not because you don't have to do malacha, but rather because it's Shabbos, so you have to recite Kiddush, so the observance of the Issa malacha is nikah, that is because of Shabbos, because he said, today is a holy day and has Kedusha, we're not allowed to do malacha. So according to Rabbi Natan, it could be that the Pshat is not called Sheyeshna Mezeh, Yeshna Mezeh, like the Tosfos Shon in the beginning of Yevam, that it's one Kedusha Sayyam, that's Mechayv and everything, and if Kedusha Sayyam is relevant for the women vis-a-vis the lav of Shomer, so it has to be relevant for everything else also. That's how the Ran apparently understood. Could the Rabbeinu Tam understood differently? The Zoch V'Shomer means that there's a connection between Malacha and Kiddush, that you want the Shvisa Malacha should be a Shvisa Anikaris, like the Loshon HaRambam. The way to make it into a Shvisa Anikaris is by reciting Kiddush, like as if Kiddush were the Brichas HaMitzvah on the Shvisa and the Malacha. And truth of the matter is, there's room to Dinsach with the Rabbeinu Tam also. The Rabbeinu Tam says, if one holds like the Ran, that women are mechuyev in shalashudas and lacha mishnah because kol sheyeshna mezeh yeshna mezeh, because the kedusha sayam is relevant for the women, for the isa malacha, it's relevant all the way. One could explain that what the Rabbeinu Tam said is incorrect. Rabbeinu Tam said you have to observe, women have to observe shalashudas and lacha mishnah, apen rab yosanes. One could dinsach with that as follows. There's a tshuva in the Chasam Sofer. Somebody asked the Chasam Sofer an interesting kasha. Why shouldn't women be obligated to wear tefillin? Because the pasuk says, "Man tiyotar Hashem aficha ki biyach hazaka atiyach Hashem in Mitzrayim." And tefillin is zechel lenes, zechel yitzias Mitzrayim. So why shouldn't women be obligated to wear tefillin? So Rabbeinu Tam has the Chasam Sofer has a short tshuva about this. So he said he points to a Tosfos. Tosfos writes in one place that the Aven HaBiyos HaNes only works on a mitzvah derabbanan. It doesn't apply to a mitzvah deraisa. All right? If it only works on it with respect to a din derabbanan, and so tefillin is a mitzvah min haTorah, so it doesn't apply to tefillin. But the other opinion, some says, according to that opinion, there's no kasha. But according to the other, you have to understand why that should be so. That's another interesting discussion. Why shouldn't it apply to mitzvah derais? But then Tais has another opinion. Often IBSNS can apply to mitzvah derais also, but only on the level of the rabbanim. It won't be mechayiv women. It won't be mechayiv women min atur. It'll be mechayiv women min the rabbanim. So yes, so why shouldn't women be mechayiv in tefillin with the rabbanim? It can't be mechayiv women min atur, because the svar often IBSNS only with the rabbanim. But let the women be mechayiv min the rabbanim to wear tefillin. That's the kasha that the Chasam Sefer deals with. So he gives a teretz. He says a very nice teretz. Rav Soloveitchik used to say the same teretz in the name of his father, Rav Moshe Soloveitchik, with a little fancier language. The exact same teretz, but a little sharper language. Rav Moshe Soloveitchik said over, I don't think he knew there was a Chasam Sefer about this. Those weren't his, he didn't have those kind of swarm at all. The Chasam Sefer and the Chuvis has these parents. And Rav Hershel Schachter worded it like this. There are two concepts, and one is Zechel HaNes, and one is Pirsum HaNes. When you eat the Haseba on Pesach night, and you drink Abukaisis, and you read the Megillah, and you light Erez Chanek, and that's the Haris of the Galas HaNes, the Ramadan. That's Pirsum HaNes. Asheni Kain, Tfilin, when a person walks with Tfilin, right away everybody sees, oh, Zechel HaNes Mitzrayim. You can't say it's Bissumi Nisa. When you read the Megillah, you're telling over the whole story. When you light the Neves Chanukah, you say, Hadimus Allah, Malandis, Malan, the Flaws. So you say, Rav Soloveitchik said us word that Amiris Hanevus Allah is Likufa. You light the Neves Chanukah, you thought Pshat and the Masech HaSofrim is. You don't recite Hadimus Allah, you're not Yotzim, because you have to be Mepharsim Nenes. You have to say, we're lighting the candle because of this. On Pesach night, you have a Seben Abakas, and you say a whole Seder. Say a whole Agoda. Tell the whole story. So there you're accomplishing Pesumi Nisa. So when you want to be Mepharsim as Hanes, then you say women are just as Mechuyim as men because Avin Habiyos Hanes, it's Pesumi Nisa. But in Tefillin, you can't say there's Pesumi Nisa. It doesn't come to anybody's mind. If you'll open up the Parshias, if you'll open up the bottom, open up the Parshias, it mentions Yetzias Mitzrayim there. So the most you can say is that it's Zechel HaNes, but you can't really say that it's Pesumi Nisa. That's what the Chasam Sefer says, the only time Rav Moshe Soloveitchik said it in this terminology, but the Chasam Sefer and the Chuvus Chiluk Arachaim says the same. The only time they say that women are obligated because Achen Habiyos HaNes, if the nature of the Nes is, if nature of the Mitzvah is Pesumi Nisa. Rav Moshe Soloveitchik just added on another knage that the Chasam Sefer doesn't have. And how can you tell in any given Mitzvah whether it's Pesumi Nisa or Zechel HaNes only? He said the similar dover is that you recite a bracha shos anisa. So on Mikra Megillah you say a bracha shos anisa. Look, as there is Chanukah, you say shos anisa. On Pesach night, even though we don't recite shos anisa in conjunction with the Haseba and the Abakaisis, but the Rishonim write in their commentary on the Haggadah that when we recite the bracha Asher Yolad Golas Hatzinim in Mitzrayim, that's the equivalent of shos anisa. That takes the place of the bracha shos anisim. You really should have said shos anisim on Pesach night, because the mitzvahs that you're performing are pirsumi nisim. It is pirsumi nisim. So the bracha shem yolanu that you recite over the second cup of wine, right before moitzi matzah, so that takes the place of the bracha shos anisim. So getting back over here, the rabbi, the Tam said that women are mechuyim in shalosh shudas and halacha mishnah because avin ha'avir sanas. So really, one can ding zil with the rabbi in the tam. You can say he's right halacha lemaisa. Women are mechuyim, but maybe for the reason that the Ran gave, because kol sheyesh nemesham yesh nemezocha. It's one package deal. Either the kedusha sayyam is mechayim them or it's not mechayim. So since the kedusha sayyam is relevant for the women, vis-a-vis the yisr malacha, the lav, aloy says the shazman rabbi men are mechuyim, so it's mechayim them. Them and everything. That's what the Ran said. One can say the reason the Rabbi Natam is not so mukhrach. You can say Shalashudis and Lech Mishnah. Anybody sees a Jew eating Shalashudis, reading Lech Mishnah, right away he knows it's Pirsumi Nisa. Right away what comes to mind is the Zechel HaMan. Not necessarily. It's not Mepharsim. You can't say it's Pirsumi Nisa. Zechel HaNes. Zechel HaNes. You can't say Pirsumi Nisa. It's really room to dinza with the Rabbi Natam. Shlomo Kluger lived in Galicia. In Galicia, there were a lot of Hasidim. By the Hasidim, many Hasidim, the practice is that women don't eat Shalashudas. And many Hasidim The women are in the kitchen when the husband says hamoitzi. The women come into the dining room and the husband gives them a slice of challah. They say their own hamoitzi, so they don't have lechem mishnah. So it's not really right. The Rav and the Rabbeinu Tam both said women are mechuyev in shalashudas and lechem mishnah. So it's not right that they don't eat shalashudas. They should listen. They should be sitting down at the table when the husband says hamoitzi and the lechem mishnah to the yotze. The Bishlam Kluger writes to defend the practice of the Hasidim, that the women are mezazel in the lechem mishnah, the shal shudas. So he says, well, look, it's a machlekes, the Rabbeinu Tam. Rabbeinu Tam doesn't hold like the Ran, the Ran doesn't hold like Rabbeinu Tam. So he left with nothing. Each one shoots the other one down, so he left with nothing. So the women are not mechuyev in shal shudas, not mechuyev in lechem mishnah. So Chacham Avadya writes, one of his Jews, how did he wave a magic wand over here? What did he do? They both said the same thing. I mean, the Tam and the Ran said, Allah Hamai said the same thing. Women are mechuyev in shal shudas, lechem mishnah. They just gave two different explanations. So even if you say the Rabbi Natan doesn't agree with the Ran's explanation, Ran doesn't agree with Rabbi Natan, he left with nothing. He left that they gave the same psak that women are mechuyev in shal shudas and lechem mishnah. It's interesting, this shaila, where they say, kol sheyeshna bazeh, yeshna bazeh, that if the one kedusha sayam, that's mechayim and everything, this shaila, the Rabbi Natan doesn't say like that. Rabbi Natan sanaf and Rabbi Yosanes. And the Ran said, kol sheyeshno. It's one kedusha sayam, that's mechayim and everything. So either the women are mechayim and all, or mechayim and nothing. This shaila comes up in another context. The Amar Brachas tells us that Rav Tzodish al Shabbos Be'er Shabbos. Rav sometimes had the practice, he would daven Ma'ariv early. Usually, we don't daven Ma'ariv until Lilo. And Rav Yudah's opinion is that you have to finish davening every day. You have to finish davening mincha by plag a mincha. After plag a mincha, you can already start davening ma'ariv. So Rav, the Kabbalah's Tosef for Shabbos, Rav would daven ma'ariv early. Rav told us all Shabbos, Be'er Shabbos, he would daven ma'ariv early after plag a mincha when the sun is still shining. So the Gemara asks a question. Did he recite Kiddush also, or did he not recite Kiddush? It's only for davening ma'ariv. Is that ma'ariv be Kabbalah Tosef for Shabbos? Or is it for Kiddush as well? So the Gemara says, yes. Toshma, he said Kiddush also. So if he said Kiddush, the din says you have to have Kiddush b'makom sudur. So if he said Kiddush when the sun is still shining, so you have to start the meal when the sun is still shining. Can you finish the meal when the sun is still shining? You eat the whole meal and you bench up before the sun sets and you might say Suda Shabbos during this man of Tosef Shabbos? Well, it means no, you can begin the meal, but you have to eat the kazayas, the kibetza, yosim, the kibetza, however much challah you have to eat for Suda Shabbos. There are three different opinions in the Poskim and Shulchan Aruch, how much you have to eat, kazayas, the kibetza, tzas, yosim, the kibetza. So maybe you have to be careful. You have to start eating the challah right after Havaitzik, right after the Kiddush, because you need Kiddush from Makom Suda. But then maybe you have to save some challah to the end, in order to make sure that you eat at the end of the meal. So that's 2 days in Taisus and the first daf in Arvit Pesachim. Taisus comments on the Mishnah, and the Mishnah says you shouldn't eat on Pesach night at Shetechshach, Yochel at Shetechshach. So Taisus says, Achidish, even if you mekabel Tosefes Yomtev, mekabel Pesach early, you can't be yotze the mitzvah of Korban Pesach, you can't be yotze the mitzvah of Matzah Mar, as it says, you have to eat dafka balayla. And you have to eat the matzah also balayla. Where of tochel matzah? You have to eat balayla. During this month of Tosef, it's tasted as a chidish. Not all the Mishayim agree. Other Mishayim disagree. You can eat mekabel Tosef as yontif. You can finish eating the Korban Pesach before the sun sets. You finish the whole Haggadah, the whole seed piece in the side of Mishayim. During this month of Tosef, Tosef disagrees. So he says you can't be yotze matzah and korban pesach during this man of Tosef. It has to be dafke. Vachlos habasa balayla hazeh, and ba'erev tochel matzah has to be at night. So Tosef raises the question: what about any other Shabbos and Yontif? Can you be yotze suda Shabbos and Yontif during this man of Tosef? But he say no. Tosef is only for isa meloch and for kiddush, but not benegayet any other mitzvah. So the two opinions, and the Taz and Shulchan Aruch quotes the two opinions, says the proper practice is lahachmir. Even in the summertime, in a lot of communities, they daven ma'ariv early, and people go up and make kiddush when the sun is still shining. You start eating when the sun is still shining, but you just save a little bit of challah till the end of the meal to eat after Lila, after Tzitzit Kachav. I remember a few years ago I was invited to visit in the yeshiva in Berlin. There's a yeshiva in East Berlin that they called Hill Simon Seminar. So they invited me to come for a week and give shiurim. The official language of instruction is English, even though all the people are, almost everybody is Russian. And the unofficial language is Russian. But the official language of instruction is English because both the boys' school and the girls' school are run by two British young men, Tamir Chacham, and they speak English. So the official language of instruction, both the girls' school is around 6 blocks away from the boys' school in Berlin, like a seminary for girls, and the yeshiva for the boys, so the official language, I was there for a week. So I remember on a Friday afternoon, then they asked me to give a shiur for an hour. Gave a shiur for an hour, it still was not sunset. The sunset was very late, something like 10:30 or something like that. Then the Tzitzit Kachav was doomsday. Tzitzit Kachav was upset. An hour and a half after, the Nashmashes took forever. So remember, I washed, and the Rabbeim take turns who eats with the Talmidim on Friday night. So there was a Rebbe sitting next to me, and I was here. So we both said Amaitzi, we said Kiddush, said Amaitzi at the beginning of the meal, and then we left over some challah for the end. I didn't think it was my place to tell the Talmidim we should all leave over challah. I was just a guest. I was surprised the Rebbe didn't tell. All the Talmidim made up all the challah. And then the Talmidim noticed that both of us, at the end, acharei kechlos alkol, after the whole meal was all over, after the dessert was served and everything, and we looked at our watch and we saw it says kechavim, so we both ate some of the challah. So the Talmidim noticed something very strange, and so he came over and asked, why do we save over challah to the end? So we told him it's 2 days in the Tosfos. So according to one opinion, you're not yet to Suda Shabbos during this man of Tosefos. You have to eat it, you have to say Sakharab. So they felt bad why we didn't tell them in advance. So they knew for the next Shabbos. They knew for all the next of the Shabbos. So that's 2 days in Tosfos. So what exactly are the 2 days in Tosfos? So the Gemara says you can be Yetzir Kiddush. The Gemara had a suffix. Is Tosefos Shabbos only for Issa Melocha? Into Davni Meirev, or is it even for Kiddush? The Gemara says, yeah, you can say Kiddush also. So the Gemara says you can say Kiddush, it means all the mitzvahs Hayom can be fulfilled during this man of Tosefos, or it means no, there's a special link, a special connection between Kiddush and Malacha. The purpose of the role of the Kiddush is that the Malacha should be Shvisa Hanikaris, Shvisa Malacha Hanikaris, like the Lashon HaRama. So if you have an Issa Malacha during this man of Tosefos, so you can say Kiddush. But it doesn't mean you can fulfill any of the other mitzvahs hayat. So that's a beferish machlokes in the Rishayim, whether this man of Tosefos is only for Issa Malacha with Kiddush because there's a special link, a special connection between the two of them to accomplish that the Shvisa Malacha should be a Shvisa Hanikaris, or it's for all the mitzvahs hayat apply. There's a Ramah in Hilchas Sukkah. So the Ramah writes a Kiddush, just like you can't begin to recite Kiddush on Leil HaSeder till Tzeisa Kachavim, because we want to fulfill all the mitzvahs halayla, not only Matzah, not only Korban Pesach, Harbakaisis, everything, all the mitzvahs, Harbakais, everything should be balayla. So the Ramah says, we have Gzeru Shabbat HaMishasah HaMishasah Techak HaSukkahs. So on Sukkahs also, you're only Yotze Yeshiva B'Sukkah if you eat balayla. You have to eat balayla after Tzeisa Kachavim. So the Ramah says, therefore, even though usually we say you can recite Kiddush during this man of Tosefos, you can be Mekabel Shabbos early this man and recite Kiddush during this man of Tosefos, but on Pesach night, you don't say Kiddush during this man of Tosefos because you have to have Davke Balaylo. So on Sukkot night also, you shouldn't recite Kiddush. You would be able to recite Kiddush, but at the end of the Kiddush, you're going to say Alach Leisha Basuka. Leisha Basuka, you can't say during this man of Tosefos. Because the Tosefos is only good, it doesn't make it into Lila. So the Sefer Dibri Yecheskel, one of the big Rabbanim from Slobodka Yeshiva in Europe, he quotes a kasha that was in the floating around in the yeshivas in the name of Rav Chaim Soloveitchik. True, you can't fulfill a mitzvah of achilas, achila b'sukkah Lila harishayin, during this man of Tosefos, but there's a mitzvah of sukkahs, to eat the sukkah all 7 days of sukkah, not just Laila Arish. So, and all sukkahs long you say Leisha Basukkah. So why can't you say Kiddush Mibod Yom, say Kiddush during this man of Tosefos, Erev Sukkahs, sit in the sukkah and say the bracha Leisha Basukkah, so you won't be out to the mitzvah of Achila Basukkah, Laila Arisha now. You'll be out to the mitzvah of Achila Basukkah, period. and you'll continue to eat a kazayis later to be yotze the mitzvah of achila b'layla harish. That's what he quotes a kasha b'shem Rav Chaim on the Rama. So he answers, no, Rav Cheskel Borstein, he answers, no. The Rama is alluding to the fact that there is a, clearly there's an opinion in the Rishonim that the only two mitzvahs that apply during Zman Tosefes is Shvisa v'Malacha and Kiddush, no other mitzvahs. And the mitzvah of Yeshiva B'Sukkah Kol Shiva doesn't apply yet during this Zman Tosefes. Not only the Laila Harishon mitzvah, the mitzvah from all 7 days also doesn't apply. Tosefes is only chal with respect to Shvisa v'Malacha and Kiddush, because Kiddush is connected. Zachar v'Shamah Debrach means that there's a connection between Kiddush and Shvisa v'Malacha, that is via Shvisa Hanikaris. So this apparent machlokes between the Ran and the Rabbi Natan, why the women are mechuyev in Arbekais, why the women are mechuyev in Shalashudis and Lech Mishnah, they both said the same thing, bottom line. Allah Almighty, the women are just as mechuyev as the men in Shalashudis and Lech Mishnah, but for two totally different reasons. Rabbi Natan says, Afen Habiyos Anes, and it could be the Ran disagrees, because Tony Zechel Anes, it could be it's not Pisuminis, and so it shouldn't apply. And the Ran says, the reason why women are mechuyev because Kol Sheyeshno, he understood Kol Sheyeshno means all the mitzvahs hayom, the Raisa, the Rabban, everything stems from the Kedusha Sayyim. So if the Kedusha Sayyim is relevant for women vis-a-vis the Yisr, then the Kedusha Sayyim are relevant for everything. So Rabbi Natan apparently doesn't understand like that. Rabbi Natan seems to have understood Kol Sheyeshno just means that there's a special link between Kiddush and Shvisa Mamalacha to make it a Shvisa Hanikeres from Mamalacha. Once delivered a yahrzeit shir. He used to have yahrzeit for his father on Gimel Shvat. People came, hundreds of people came. People would fly in from out of town to listen to the shir. He used to give a shir for 4 hours straight. People were glued to their seats. It started at 8 o'clock at night, went at least till 12. And the people were prepared to sit another 4 hours. He was such an entertaining speaker. He was such a marvelous balmazber. So on one occasion, he was discussing a tshuva in the Netziv, in the Meshav Dover. Eshadav has the following shayla. A woman benched licht early erev yantav. She was a mekabel yantav. After she benches licht before the shkia, she gets a telegram that her mother died. So the din is that if one started sitting shiva before yantav, the yantav comes and cancels shiva. But she was ready mekabel yantav. So she didn't ask a shayla. She benched licht and she got the telegram that mother died. So she took off her shoes in order to observe Availus a few minutes before Yantav, and now the shaila is, was that valid? She was Mekabel Yantav already, so you say it's already Simchas Yantav, you can't sit Shiva on Yantav, they say no. Tosefes Yantav is only for Yisra Malach and for Kiddush. It doesn't imply that the other aspects of the mitzvah Sayyim apply. So there's not yet a mitzvah of Simcha, so she did right, she took off her shoe, she observed Availus a little bit, and Yantav comes and cancels the Shiva. So the Netziv has a whole tshuva about this. That's exactly the deal. When you're mekabel to Sefer Shabbos, mekabel to Sefer Yantiv, is it only relevant for Yisra Malach and Kiddush, Vesulo? Well, no, it's relevant for all. It's one package deal. Everything goes together. Once you're mekabel to Sefer Yantiv, so it's chal benegir to everything. So that's basically a fundamental machlokes HaRishonim.